Leading the complaints was Charles Onen, the vice chairperson, Rules, Discipline and Privileges, who expressed fears that the probe into Zake's conduct that started in November 2022 might go into 2024, something he deems unnecessary.
We are going for Christmas, and this issue should not actually proceed up, should not take us to next year. For me, I'm tired of coming for this same issue. Time and again, we are sitting here. The issue of Zake, the issue of Zake. We should actually conclude with this issue, and then we start other business.
Meda Duluwega, the Busira East Member of Parliament, another witness who appeared before the committee today, noted that the case should be thrown out on grounds that litigants are not cooperative. Segona warned that he is giving this committee only one more chance to appear, or else he will never again honor their invitation to testify.
I can only say, elsewhere where I work, when the state loses interest in a matter, they withdraw. And you cannot hold people hostage forever. Considering my schedule, as you will kindly appreciate, I'll only give this attempt one more chance to appear. Beyond that, please don't waste ink.
Another witness, John Baptist Nambeshe, the Majia County Member of Parliament, called out the Rules Committee for its selective summons to the witnesses, wondering why he is not appearing alongside Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayewa, who was presiding over the sitting at the fated day.
Mediation meeting after our retreat, after that suspension of 5 minutes, then would have been here together and I would be more comfortable here with the then presiding officer. But that is missing on the list of witnesses. It leaves me wondering whether it is selective application of the rules.
Whereas the committee had convened to wrap up inquiry into the case of misconduct against MP Zake, which he allegedly committed in November 2022 when he protested on the floor of parliament, the meeting flopped on grounds of lack of quorum.
Looking at the quorum, the fourth estates, they're actually the media team. They are more than the what? The committee members. And it is like I'm the only one who has some special interest on this case, which is not the case, almost like this issue, we cannot actually proceed. You are aware that most of the members are in Kigali for the tournament. And those who are around, about five, they have sent apologies that they cannot attend.
Matters became more complicated as Zake's lawyer, Erias Lukwago, failed to show up to cross-examine the witness due to a mix-up in committee communications, and proceedings were adjourned to a later date. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.